Good morning to all of you. Now we are talking about the backtracking search in CSP, that is constant satisfaction problem. The term backtracking search is used for a depth first search that chooses values for one variable at a time and backtrack when a variable has no legal values left to assign. That means the backtracking is work just like a depth first search and that choose one variable at a time. Ekach variable ekach लेवलवरचा एक व्हेरिएबल घेणार आहे, त्यानंतर त्या व्हेरिएबलला ट्रॅक करत जाणार आहे आपण. त्याच्यानंतर जो सेकंड व्हेरिएबल आहे त्याच लेवलमधला, दॅट आय एम गोइंग टू टेक अँड आय एम गोइंग टू बॅक ट्रॅक इट. सो द टर्म बॅक ट्रॅक सर्च इज यूज्ड फॉर अ डेप्थ फर्स्ट सर्च अँड दॅट यूज अ व्हॅल्यूज फॉर वन व्हेरिएबल ॲट अ टाइम. सो इट इज गोइंग टू टेक वन व्हेरिएबल ॲट अ टाइम अँड बॅक ट्रॅक व्हेन व्हेरिएबल हॅज नो लीगल व्हॅल्यूज लेफ्ट टू असाइन. It repeatedly chooses an assigned unassigned variable and then tries all values in the domain of that variable, in turn trying to find a solution. It means it is going to finish first level, after that it is going to finish a second level. So it is just like a depth first search. In case of depth first search, when you take any node, we are going to find out the legal values in such a way that first level should complete for all the values. After that is going at the next level. So here we are going to use that depth first search as just like a backtracking. In case of inconsistency is detected, then returns failure and causing the previous call to try another value. Now how it is going to apply? The backtracking algorithm constant contains a single line. Variable is select unassigned variable, that is CSV. The simplest strategy for select unassigned variable means we have to select unassigned variable as a variable. So the simplest strategy for select unassigned variable is to choose the next unassigned variable in the order x1 x2. So first we assign a single variable, we are applying. If it is a legal value, we are proceeding. If it is not a legal value, we are taking next value. The static variable ordering results in the most efficient search. For example, after the assignment for W as red and NT as green, there is only one possible value for SA. So it makes sense to assign SA as blue next rather than assigning Q. So we are talking about the map coloring problem of previous. Here, suppose I have assigned red to a WA region and green to a NT region, then for the SA there will be only one value and that will be the blue. So I am assigning blue to the SA region, that will be the legal value. In fact, after SA is assigned, the choice for the Q, NSW and V are all forced. This intuitive idea choosing the variable with the fewest legal values is called as minimum remaining values. So that is called as MRV. MRV means minimum legal values. What are the legal values remaining? That is called as MRV. For example, suppose I assign red color to a WA region and green color to NT region, then there will be one color remaining, that is blue, for the SA region. If I assign blue to the SA region, then automatic for the Q, NSW and V all have the fewest remaining values, that is called as legal values, and that legal value is called as MRV. It also has been called as the most constant variable or fail first heuristic, the latter because it picks up the variable that is most likely to cause a failure soon, thereby pruning the search tree. If some variable X has no legal values left, the MRV heuristic will select X and failure will be detected immediately, avoiding pointless searching through the other variables. It means, what are the minimum remaining values that are called as legal values? First, we assign with any value. If I am assigning with any value, then apart from nearby region, I can assign the same values. But for the neighboring values, I have to assign the different values. So, if the domain has been reduced, then there should be some legal values which are remaining. And that legal values should be minimum remaining values, and that is also called as most constant variable. Now next point is interleaving search and inference. One of the simplest form of inference is a forward checking. Whenever a variable x is assigned, the forward checking process establishes arc consistency for it for each unassigned variable y that is connected to x by a constraint delete from y's domain any value that is inconsistent with the value chosen for x. It means if x and y are consistently or if x and y are constrained in such a manner that there is an arc consistency is established. So if each unassigned variable y that is connected to x by a constraint then delete y's domain for any value that is inconsistent with the value of chosen for x. It means that if x has a particular domain and if x is related to y then obviously y have also the domain as x. So what are the extra values for the y that should be reduced or that should be removed? That is called as forward checking. Forward checking is nothing but there should be some arc consistency. If there is arc consistency between the two variables, then there should be a common domain. Because if there are variables x and y, and if x has a particular domain, and this x is related to y with arc consistency, then obviously domain of x and domain of y will be same. And if there are different values for the domain of y, then the different value should be reduced. So after w as red and q as green are assigned, the domain of nt and sa are reduced to a single value. It means w is red and q is green are assigned, the domain for nt and sa are reduced to a single value. We have eliminated branching of these variables altogether by propagation information for w and q. Our second point is that after v is blue and domain of sa is empty, hence forward checking has detected that the partial assignment w as red, q as green and v as blue is inconsistent with the constraint of the problem and the algorithm will therefore backtrack immediately. Now we will elaborate with this example. Now these are the regions of the map. We are talking about the map coloring problem, but we are thinking in a different manner now. Initial domain will be RGB for all the regions. Now suppose I start with W as red. For WA region, I am assigning red color. So here is the WA, I am assigning red color. Now this is the neighbor, so I cannot assign a red color. So there should be two domains G and B. Two values of the for the NT, G and B. For Q, Q is not a neighbor. Q is not a neighbor of WA, so I can assign any one of the three values. NW, it is also not a neighbor, so I can assign any of the three values. For the V also, I can assign any of the three values. But for the SA is again the neighbor of WA, so I cannot assign a red, but I can assign two values, either G or B. I can assign one value from G or B. Again for the T, it is not a neighbor, so I can assign any of the three values. Now suppose I assign red color. Now for the Q, I want to assign a green color. Okay. Now if there is a green color I want to assign, then I cannot assign a green color. So I can already have assigned a red color. So I'm starting with NT. So as NT is neighbor, okay. So it is a neighbor, then I cannot assign a green color, but there is only one value that will be the blue. Here also I can assign R or B, but I cannot assign a G because it is a neighbor of NSW is a neighbor of Q. So like this, I am assigning the color, but I am assigning those color by checking whether it is a neighbor or not. After that, assign V as a blue. So I can already assign red color to WA, NT to B color to the NT. So like this I am going to reduce. Now for the T I have the three variables, I can assign any of the three values. So this was example where I have reduced, I use forward checking. Forward checking manje kay tar samja measure suruvat keli and W region la red color dila asel tar mi kontyahi neighbor region la red color deu shakat nahi pan teen paiki kutlai color mi other than neighbors la deu shakto. तर पहिल्या स्टेप्समध्ये मला रिड्यूस करायचे आहेत ते म्हणजे नेबर्स. त्याच्यानंतर दुसऱ्या स्टेपमध्ये मी दुसरं ग्रीन कलर दिला मी क्यूला, कारण ऑलरेडी रेड कलर ओके आणि ब्ल्यू कलर इथे दिला मी, कारण क्यूसाठी मी समजा ग्रीन कलर दिला असेल तर एकच कलर अप्लाय झाला तो म्हणजे ब्ल्यू फॉर द एंट्री रिजन. अँड आय कॅन असाईन आयदर ऑफ द टू व्हॅल्यूज आर अँड बी फॉर एन एस डब्ल्यू. सो लाईक दिस आय एम गोईंग टू चेक इट फॉरवर्डली. सो वेन यू सी द मॅप यू गोईंग टू अंडरस्टँड हाऊ इट इज गोईंग टू अप्लाय. सो दिस वॉज अ फिगर द प्रोसेस ऑफ मॅप कलरिंग सर्च विथ फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग. डब्ल्यू एज रेड इज असाईन फर्स्ट, देन फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग डिलीट्स रेड फ्रॉम द डोमेन ऑफ द नेबरिंग. नेबर जे असतील त्याला आपण रेड कलर देऊ शकत नाही, सो इट इज गोईंग टू डिलीट फ्रॉम द डोमेन. आफ्टर क्यू एज ग्रीन इज असाईन, ग्रीन इज डिलीटेड फ्रॉम द डोमेन्स ऑफ द एन टी एस एड एन एच बी बिकॉज दीज आर द नेबर्स. आफ्टर व्ही इज ब्ल्यू इज असाईन, द ब्ल्यू इज डिलीटेड फ्रॉम द डोमेन्स ऑफ एन एस डब्ल्यू. सो लाईक दिस दिस इज कॉल्ड एज फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग. फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग म्हणजे काय, तर पहिल्यांदा एक कलर आपण दिला, त्यानंतरचे जे जे रिजन्स असतील किंवा जे नेबर्स असतील त्या नेबर्सला आपण तो कलर द्यायचा नाही, तर तो कलर त्या डोमेनमधून डिलीट करायचा. सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग. फॉर मेनी प्रॉब्लेम द सर्च विल बी मोर इफेक्टिव इफ वी कंबाईन एम आर व्ही हेरॉस्टिक विथ फॉरवर्ड चेकिंग. नाव कन्सिडर फिगर आफ्टर द असाइनिंग डब्ल्यू एस रेड, दॅट मीन्स वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर लास्ट फिगर. It seems that the assignment constant its neighbors NT and SA, so we should handle those variables next and then all the variables will fall into place. That is exactly what happens with MRB. NT and SA have two values, so one of them is chosen first, then the other and then Q, NS, W and V in order. Finally, T has the three values and any one of them. So this was the just explanation of what we have talk about the map coloring problem. So this was the end of the session. If you have any doubts, any question, you can put on the comments. Thank you.